6 days ago, there were no confirmed coronavirus cases in New York, but officials back then were expecting some and possibly many cases. And now?
We had 11 cases as of yesterday. With the testing we did last night, we have an additional 11, so we're at 22 cases. Eight of those additional cases are connected to a gentleman we have in Westchester, two people in New York City who are currently hospitalized, and one in Long Island and a hospital in Nassau County.
Right after the governor spoke, New York City's mayor, in a separate event, gave details about the two new cases in New York City. Neither patient had traveled to countries with high numbers of cases.
Both are critically ill at this moment. Both did have substantial pre-existing conditions.
One is a woman in her 80s whose health is compromised by age-related conditions. The other patient is a man in his 40s, a smoker and a vape user. One's in a Brooklyn hospital, the other in a hospital in Manhattan. Considering that New York is the fourth most populous state, with nearly 20 million people having fewer than two dozen cases.
That's striking, but we're all very sober right now about what tomorrow could bring.
It's why the health commissioner issued this new executive order requiring any city worker who's been to the five countries most strongly affected by coronavirus and shows symptoms to be tested for the illness known as COVID-19. The city has enough testing supplies to screen 1,000 people. That's not enough.
The test capacity right now, we need to get to the point where we can do hundreds a day, every day, maybe even more at some point. And we're not there yet.
But again, he says the need to get there is very serious. Even though the number of cases is comparatively very small, it could grow exponentially, much the way it has done in other countries. He's calling on the federal government to step in and make sure that private labs can help make more testing kits available. Reporting live from Lower Manhattan, I'm James Ford, Pix 11 News.